movie Hound the Man.
I tell you what you watch right now, if you're a Star Wars guy, you watch The Mandalorian. Holy cow, that is excellent.
You know, I was talking about this the other day. I would like to get into the world where I, because I've seen Star Wars movies, I've seen the different ones, but not in a straight order. I mean, and it's not really in an order because the newest is actually the first, and it kind of goes backwards.
Well,
and
just start at episode one and then watch it straight through. Because I mean, those are the three prequels, 1, 2, and 3. So just watch those in order. You know, 4, 5, and 6 is the original trilogy, but they put 3 movies out for prequels to that. But just watch them all in order because it all goes in order. It all ties in order that way now. Watch Rogue One, which is my favorite Star Wars movie. And you can watch Solo. Solo is a good just in-between movie. It's okay. And
so,
watch all that. Watch The Mandalorian because I think you're probably going to need the movies at some point to understand The Mandalorian. Right now, these first 2 episodes, I think you just pick up and watch The Mandalorian and you're fine. But I think things are going to happen in it, and characters are going to show up that you wouldn't know what the deal is if you didn't know the movie. So, yeah, watch The Mandalorian. If you have not had a chance, definitely watch it. It's holy Jesus good.
It's holy Jesus
so far.
Good.
Holy Jesus. It's really
anything
good.
Like,
so far.
Anything like touchdown Jesus?
Yeah, not even kind of.
So I noticed I got the Disney Prime because I got the Apple TV. So long story, a few weeks ago, my friend, you know, I text people and she's like, watching Guardian of the Galaxy. I'm like, oh, I've never seen that. She goes, oh, you got to watch it. So I wasn't doing anything and I'd had a few adult beverages and I'm like, what the heck? Here, well, I'll start watching it. Well, I couldn't find it on Netflix or anything. And so I text my friend back and she goes, oh, you got to download the Disney Prime. So first of all, I got kidnapped into buying the Disney Prime, but now I see all the Star Wars movies is on Disney Prime. And I've tried 3 times to watch Guardians of the Galaxy. I think it's funny. I think it's good. It's the kind of thing I like. But every single time I fell asleep and didn't make it all the way through the end. But I do like the raccoon.
Yeah, and I think you'll do Star Wars the same way. It's just one of those things that it's really good. It's like The Godfather. Like, I'm that way watching The Godfather. I've seen The Godfather probably 20 times, but I've never once watched The Godfather all the way through because I fall asleep every time at different points of the movie, and I wake up at different points of the movie. But stitch all that together, then I've probably seen The Godfather in its total about 20 times, but I fall asleep during it every time.
All right, Rick Riggin, our official college football contributor. Where can people find your work and your masterpieces, sir?
I'm just all over Twitter. That's my masterpiece. You know, it's talked about UE basketball this year beating Kentucky. I think that Cinderella story's wore off because now UE's lost 2 games since then. So
we knew that wouldn't last. we knew that wouldn't last forever.
Goodness.
Well, sir, I look forward to good reports about your smoked turkey. Let me know how that works out for you. Maybe I'll try it next year.
All right, will do.
All right. Rick Riggin, our official college football contributor. My name is Tom Marcus Del Presidente. 917-889-8516 is our digit. Up on the other side is Mo from the BS Sports Show. We're going to continue our NFL talk, and we'll see what comes out on the other end of that. My name is Tom Marcus Del Presidente. We'll be right back right here on the Collins Radio Network.
No, this can't be right. Hey, baby, come on. I loved you.
I can't believe it.
I've been playing 4-on-4 with a barbershop quartet.
Pass the ball, pass the rock. We're open, just pass the ball.
Nah, I can't believe how easy it was to save hundreds of dollars on my car insurance with Geico.
Yeah.
Believe it, Geico could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Morning face. You get it when you don't sleep well. This is what happened to Linda.
Morning, guys.
Good morning. Ah, what is that thing?
It's me, Linda.
Oh, my God, it talks. Run!
No, it's me, Linda, from HR.
It looks hungry. Save the children. Save them. Stay back. I've got mace.
Ow, they're hitting my eyes.
We're moving.
It's called beauty sleep for a reason. And there's never been a better time to get some.
Get 20% off IKEA Sultan mattresses. IKEA, love your home.
Here's to the straggly ones. The first ones. The hey, I look good with this ones. The black, brown, red, and gray ones. The itchy ones. The ones grown by dad. The ones grown for dad. The I nearly didn't do it this year ones, and the absolutely filthy ones, they all raise awareness, raise funds, start conversations, and save lives. Because whatever you grow, will save a bro. Sign up now at Movember.com.
Back then, I was a little baby, sweet and greasy. Gotta love bread.
I know. You know, there's sandwich bread over there next to the coffee.
I eat bread in the bathtub.
Okay, that's gross to me.
There's a lot I've been feeling lately.
Well, it helps if I turn on my mic. Welcome back to The Balance. My name's Mark Vassell, Presidente. Joining us now is Mo from the BS Sports Show. Mo, how in the world are you?
Good. I was jealous listening to Rick talking about him smoking his turkey. My turkey is actually trying to quit, so this year we're just having a turkey with a patch on it. So it'll be different. Different.
The quit smoking cold turkey commercial.
Yes. Yeah.
Oh, that cracks me up. That's funny. Yeah. How are you going to make your turkey this year, sir?
I'm not. I have people who do that. I don't cook.
Hey, man. You got to get in the kitchen, man. I'm a world-famous chef. That's, you know, everything I make is pretty much world-famous. If you follow me on Facebook or Twitter, everybody knows that. I'm making a Cajun Creole turkey. It's gonna be good. Yummy. Any Thanksgiving tradition?
I decided just to get married, just so I could. Asked me to cook Thanksgiving dinner. That's the only reason I really got married.
Funny, that's the reason I got divorced. No.
Nice.
Oh, the in-laws did not like me. No, I'm just kidding. Well, let's get into this conversation. We were having a little bit of this conversation earlier with Rick and this Myles Garrett and the race car. I mean, we titled the show Play the Race Card, because here's the thing. Is racism wrong? Yes. Let's check that box off. Should he have taken off the helmet and hit Mason Rudolph? No. Let's check that box off. We talked about this on the show last week. Not one time was racism brought up, but now all of a sudden you're suspended, you're facing the NFL. Oh, well, Mason Rudolph said something racist, and yet the NFL can find no proof of that whatsoever, and he still would have got suspended for the same amount of time that he got suspended for. It doesn't justify anything. Well, he made a racist comment, so I hit him in the head with a helmet. How absurd and tired are we? Now, let's separate the question here. We don't want racism. It's not right. What I'm trying to say is, let's not use racism as a get-out-of-jail card. Go ahead.
No, I agree with you. I hate when that's used as a get-out-of-jail-free card, but here's my only thing. Knowing Myles Garrett, and having been around Myles Garrett, I've never found him to be untruthful. If anything, I think at times the Cleveland Brown coaching staff and PR staff has felt that Myles Garrett's a little too truthful with reporters and the media. So it's hard for me to believe that he doesn't believe that that was said. Now, because that scrum was going on right there, it might have been said, and it might not have been Myles Garrett. He just interpreted that. You know what I mean? Like, there was two or three other Steelers right there. Maybe he thought that it was. Because, you know, a lot of times, you know, African-Americans will tend to call each other by that name. And, you know, and it's not a derogatory way. So maybe he heard the word. And maybe it wasn't from him. Maybe it was from Pouncey. Maybe it was from one of the other guys. And he took it that way, thinking Mason Rudolph said it in the heat of battle. Here's the thing. One thing about football players and athletes in general, guys with a lot of bravado and a lot of ego, they don't like to be disrespected. So we see those fights happen with their own teams in training camp. I'm just saying, I hate when the race card's brought up if it's used as a get-out-jail-free card. I agree with you 100%. But knowing Myles Garrett, I have a hard time believing that he's lying. And maybe he's a great liar. Maybe I've just been snowballed this entire time, and he's lied to the media a bunch, and I just bought into everything he said. But he just doesn't seem like that type of dude.
Well, and here's the thing. I mean, Myles Garrett, let's face it, he's no saint. He's had his issues as far as – not that he's a dirty player, but he certainly is an aggressive player. Nothing wrong with that. You certainly would maybe want that out of your player. And I kind of respected the fact in the post game, hey, you know, I take ownership for this. I shouldn't have done it. Okay. Take ownership for it and move on. My thinking is, whether it was Mason Rudolph that said it or somebody else that said it, why didn't you lead with that? Why did you wait a whole week to say anything and only say it to the NFL?
Here's the thing about it, though. So maybe he wasn't trying to put that out there in the media. Let's look at it just from this way. Myles Garrett's wasn't trying to play this case or play his case in the media. He brought it up strictly when the investigation was done by the NFL. You know what I mean? And if that's the case, if this was said or he felt it was said, him not trying to play that in the media, I give him kudos for it. I'm not trying to be a Myles Garrett apologist by any means, because I cover Cleveland. I've been covering them for a couple of years now. All I'm saying is the fact that I respect guys not trying to play their case in the media, because we have seen a lot of guys in the past, Ezekiel Elliott, you know, try to play their case against the NFL in the media. And Myles Garrett decided not to do that. He brought the reasons that he thought he did this and the reasons he felt he was justified at the time, even though he knows it was wrong. He brought that only up to the NFL in a private meeting. Now, the fact that it was brought to Mason Rudolph's camp and Mason Rudolph's camp decided to put that out there, you know, that's a different story. But I applaud Myles Garrett for not playing that in the media, because if you're Myles Garrett and you realize this, how much you just screwed up, if you thought you were getting yourself out of trouble, wouldn't you have played that card a lot sooner in the media to bring sympathy and bring people on your side? Instead, he waited until he was interviewed by the NFL to do that. So maybe we look at it a little bit differently and put that spin on it, that, hey, all right, he tried to bring it up in private to the NFL as opposed to playing this case in the media for the last week and a half.
Okay, well, let's say that it happened. Let's just say Mason Rudolph did use the race term. And for whatever reason, the NFL couldn't find any proof. But let's just say that happened. The end result would have remained in place. You can't have players hitting other players without a helmet. I think once the helmet comes off, you kind of back off and say, okay, the fight's over.
Yeah, I agree with you 100%. Now, if you look by the letter of the rule in the NFL rule book, you can't take your helmet off to use as a weapon. It never says anything about using the other player's helmet as a weapon. So theoretically, by the letter of the law in the NFL rule book, it doesn't say anything that you can't hit another player with their helmet. No, but I agree with you. There's no place for that in the game. But at the end of the day, Tom, though, as you sit back and look at it, are you really surprised? I mean, it's a violent game. We watch these dudes crash into each other for three and a half hours. And the fact that it boiled over, I'm shocked this is the first time it's happened, though. You know what I mean? And it stinks, because I think this will be attached to him for the rest of his career, because he is a great player. He's an aggressive player. But off the field, you know, I've covered him doing some of these charity events, doing these children's hospital. He's a great dude. And these kids, that's where he really feels bad about screwing up, is the example he set for all these kids in Cleveland area that look up to him. And I think that's really what he feels worst about. You know, it was wrong. I think that the season-long suspension is enough. I don't think it should go into next year. I think the sooner that the NFL determines what the length of suspension will be, everybody will be able to move on somewhat. Until Cleveland plays Pittsburgh coming up in, a week and a half from now.
And it's going to be back up again. Hey, you know, you talk about pleading your case in the media. This brings me along the same theme songs, if you will, with the race card and this and that and the other. The drama with Colin Kaepernick never ends. And he had his opportunity. You talk about playing your case in the media.